If you don't have type 2 diabetes yourself, you most likely know someone who does. That's because it affects, listen to this, more than 29 million Americans. And for millions of them, that may mean a series of daily blood sugar checks and insulin shots that make life pretty complicated. Well, today we've got a very important, very positive treatment update that's giving countless patients their lives back. And here to tell us all about it is John Sink, physician's assistant and certified diabetes educator, and one of his patients, June Henson. So glad to have you on the show.
Wonderful. Great to be here.
All right, John, I'm going to start right with you. Tell us more about type 2 diabetes. Do a lot of patients still rely on multiple insulin shots a day?
Well, we've come a long way, but about a third of those patients you spoke about use multiple daily injections, or at least one injection a day, to help control their blood sugar because they don't produce enough insulin. Mm. And so those patients, bless their heart, they're suffering in the restaurants, and they're suffering out in public about when to take their shot. Can I take it in public? Plus, they have to carry all these devices with them, and shots and injections and syringes and vials. And so it's just very cumbersome, makes every meal an adventure for most of these folks.
Well, as I say, my grandfather was horrible. He had to carry all of this. He had six or so times a day if he was in the car or driving in or a restaurant. It was just very complicated.
Yeah, you can't do anything without thinking about your blood sugar most of the time.
Right. And June, does some of this describe your experience with type 2 diabetes, and how did it affect your freedom and your daily life?
Well, I was struggling to maintain my daily routine. And
June didn't want to be a diabetic.
No,
she
no,
pretended
I didn't.
She wasn't a diabetic.
I tried not to.
So we had to teach her.
It runs in my family, and I was struggling. And I tried other things that didn't work, and my numbers were still not in line at all.
And you said she was toxic, right?
Yeah, she was toxic. Her blood sugar levels were high, and she really needed some more insulin to help bring that glucose down. And unfortunately, you usually have to go to more injections per day to do that, but we had options for it.
I say, the good news is that there's a new treatment option. You just got to tell us all about it.
So in 2012, a company named Valeritas came out with a device called the Vigo. And the Vigo holds one type of insulin, and the patient simply takes the cover off of the needle button. They push that down, and a small needle goes up under the skin. Now, they would wear it on their arm. They could wear it on their abdomen. June frequently wears hers on her abdomen. That's where she's comfortable. But then at mealtimes, because there's insulin in here, it's constantly running, but there's a button on the side. So at meals, they push a button. Their insulin goes in. Next meal, they push the button. Insulin goes in. So they don't have to carry around the syringes and the vials.
Yes.
and sit in a restroom. They're scared to take a shot in front of people because someone might say, oh, you can't have that because you're a diabetic. So it helps with some of that embarrassment. It's also more convenient than carrying all those other items
around. Oh, it certainly is. And you said you can even just punch it through your shirt and
yeah, you can wear it under your shirt, and you know it's great for businessmen, you know, because they can just reach up and push the button, and no one ever knows they did it because they don't want anybody to know they're diabetic. So now they can kind of be a little more discreet about those if that's something that they're worried about.
Fantastic. And June, you know, you've been using this treatment now. How has it affected you? How has it changed your life?
It's got my numbers all in line now.
Wonderful. And John, tell me how that works for her. She puts it on her skin. It's got a little sticky.
She can wear it under her clothes, or she can wear it on her arm, she could wear it on her abdomen, and then she needs injections or insulin prior to each meal, so now she can do that just with a push of a button instead of carrying around insulin syringes or insulin pens or things like that. Helps her with her struggle a little bit to make it a little more like a real life instead of where's my stuff.
I don't have to do the number and then calculate how much to give me. That's done for me.
That's so fantastic. And John, I'm curious, are there clinical benefits that have been noticed with the Vigo?
Well, certainly. A lot of those patients that we spoke about, that 6 million patients, are not reaching their goal, and that's a hemoglobin A1C is their glucose measurement. And they're not reaching that goal because they miss an injection, or they don't take an injection, or they go out and forget it at home. So this device makes it a little more convenient for them to get those things that they need. And the clinical studies that have been out, all of them have shown a pretty significant reduction in A1C versus what they were taking before.
And you said this is relatively new. Do all doctors know about this?
No, unfortunately. Fortunately, this is a small company that has this device, and so they have a small team of people out there trying to get the word out and at meetings and educational meetings. So there's still a great majority in rural areas and some cities that just don't have access or haven't heard about it. And you know, hopefully we'll get that message out there at some point.
And viewers, let's get that message out there. And John, I'm just curious, where do patients and doctors go to find Vigo?
So they can go on the website if they want to. It's www.go-vigo.com. vigo.com, and there's information for patients, there's information for healthcare providers right there. They can look that up
and get going.
Get going.
Excellent. John, June, thank you so much. All the best to you, June, and thanks for being on the show. Wonderful.
Thank you.
All right, and don't forget, for more information about type 2 diabetes, log on to thebalancingact.com, and don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Twitter.